piece of the new world order, but it's an image that's very interesting. It's taken in Vatican City during Easter Mass. And Easter Mass is a time when not everybody congregates and to listen to the Pope's message to the world, the Easter blessing. So it's an extremely dense crowd and it's very colorful, the weather, it's very beautiful, so the colors here are very vibrant. The New World Order is a series of works that I discovered by really traveling the world and going to events or witnessing crowds. Most of the time I stay distant from the crowds, that's how I started taking pictures of the crowds, because I always am quite claustrophobic. So I also had a place in New York where right above the, you could see the people doing the New York Marathon below, and it's very interesting, the movement in the middle and the crowds cheering on the side. So the accumulation of masses, whether it's a sports event, a rock concert, a car race, also the crowds, they gravitate very different culturally. When I start the project, often I don't know the outcome, and I stumble on similar images that then become contextual. So when I start comparing the images and align them or shuffle them around, suddenly a project is born, and then I become more conscious of the work and I start looking for more subjects consciously. But most projects in the beginning, they start accidentally, or they're a passion project that I developed initially, but they really become works after quite many times following these patterns. Aerial point of view is very interesting, and I always like the bird view, we call it the bird view from above. Everything gets compressed. And then there was a film called Koyaanisqatsi that was released in the late 70s. It's called The Beginning and the End. And their crowds filmed on Broadway and in Japan. And you see an antheap of ants, and you see the pattern of movement of hours in a crowd is very similar of an antheap. And this was a really conscious moment for me to look at crowds. And after that, which is now really a long time ago, 50 years ago, I got more and more interested in crowd formations. It's also aesthetically very interesting. The colors are very different by culture. Like you have the heart in Mecca with the stone in the middle and these enormous crowds circling cheering an event, and then your political event, when you have flags. So this combination becomes extremely interesting. A lot of the pictures I've taken myself, but then I started seeing pictures, news pictures, and I started sometimes photographing TV screens when I was not in a certain place or in something great in the images, and then I started researching, especially during the time of COVID, when we had these broadcasts of the manifestations in Hong Kong, or we had the heart in Mecca again, where you had the same location with very, very few people, where there were masses of crowds, and you saw suddenly the social distancing in the streets, train stations, subways, airports. The transformation became very, very different. And then I started blurring the images, and they almost reminded me of similar paintings, of pointillistic paintings. And the aesthetically really fascinated me, the process, also like dots of color or splatters. So the project started growing and growing, and I think all together is maybe 8 years that I've been looking at these images and creating and recreating and adapting these images into an artwork. Again, this is always the question of the public, where are we showing? I think if it's in a gallery, it's different than in a museum. So I have not decided yet where to show these works. I'm still in the process of finishing and editing, and then the next step is a book that's in the works with Schneider. It was actually already in the catalog, but then it was not finished. I felt like adding things, and the project became more and more interesting, and also the references became more interesting. So these projects, they really grow, and I'm interested how the public is going to react, because it's really, we really witnessed a new world order. You know, we had SARS, we had Ebola, then we had massive political events, demonstrations, and we had some tragic events where crowds are being dispersed, and all this creates magic imagery. So I think it's really, it's actually a very, very interesting process. No, I thought that it would be very, very different after COVID. But when I passed the last street parade in Switzerland, actually, I saw the crowds more cramped than ever, and I see enormous crowds today, whether at the airport or a train station. I think the fear really made us stop and think, and basically also this is a very easy analysis how quick we forget and how quick we are gathering in these huge crowds again, even though we know how We need to think about it. I think these images are once and one with it. I think it will be a very interesting project to show.